The Singing Tadpole, or The Pig in the Pond. An Invitation from Chaos by Thessalonius Loyola. Three blinks of an eye. In the misty distance, beneath the hazel tree, a salmon leaps, splashing. Later, ungently persuaded by the force called G, he returns to his elements. The two instants disexist, later to reform as the subtle image blocks of tainted history, if I write or remember them. But the new, fresh instant contains the salmon's leap and fall. All the fishy leaping and falling that ever was is encapsulated in its past. The potential future of this new instant, attenuated by knowledge of the salmon's leap, twists and shifts the multiversal destination. All change. The Coracle. I sit still in my round boat, breathless and wide-eyed, alert to the vibrant particles of happenstance exploding silently around me in the dark, unmoving air. Snake-eyed with hunter's intent, I stalk the avenues of improbability, motionless and empty-headed. There is no star or chart to guide my way between the moments. No one was here before. In time long past, I teased the multiverse to tell me truth. As I choose. In my wizardry, I run time slow, finding space between the moments to sift and strain the deposits of time with pan-like perception, searching ibis-beaked for that instant of all instants where and when my intent is least improbable. Then the oar goes in, my caracular craft taking direction from me, unneedful of rudder, while I know my desire. I see the salient salmon leap, but that is of no moment. I prowl a different prey, long distant, but nearer, now the multiverse has changed, once again, in my favor. Eating my onion, I deny attention to small, glittering objects in the undergrowth. I scry the canopy of leaves against the dark sky, unmindful of giant birds and looming gods who press their images on me. No need for eyes in this looming dark, for feet and hands, guided by the feeling tendrils of the weird web, find their own way out and home. No danger in the dark. My onion links a taste from time before, of sweet-mouthed kisses unintended to offend, and times of magic past in this place process before the inner eye, softly forging link on link the chain that never hammer saw. On the bank, a host of figures, robed and masked, unmoving, fix their gaze on the man with the onion, pondering his own state. Moving again, a tree takes me, an insect in a brittle hand. I struggle to escape with slow, unfrantic movements, then give myself in calm surrender, like a true onion eater. My surrender makes me free, and I expand to fill the world between the worlds. The tree, an incidental snare, in a wood full of diamonds. I join the host, and all the masks are changed. It makes no difference. The goddess, a forger herself and wise to wizardcraft, knows we are not fools. Bottle returned to sender. Omar, of the old times, tried many a wise man's door, but later lamented the time misspent in argument, having found his genius in a bottle. Following in his sagely steps, I mounted an expedition to the east. The bottle I found was empty, so I breathed my own spirit in and corked it tight forever. A bottle is always a comfort on a cold night. Some cold is caused by scrutiny. If I stare too long and hard, the magic dissolves to nothing, like a word nine times repeated, or a prayer too often uttered. The indiscriminate word tumbles from the mouth of every would-be mage, with or without the counterfeit courage of the bottle, regardless of time, place, or meaning. He who has ears to hear, let him listen to that reckless rhetoric, and then make up his own mind. Listen, you torturers of innocent words. I will follow you, if you will follow me. me. A feast is as good as enough. I know a pool where the salient salmon grows fat on nuts and knowledge. I divine the instant of his capture, but should I cast a hierophantic hook or spin the web between the moments of his leap and fall? I weave the web, avoiding hurt, and in the third instant he is mine, glad and rejoicing that I have not caught a man as Christian folk are wont to do. I haul him in and off with his head. This I save to talk with at my leisure. The rest I spit upon an oaken hearth, moist-mouthed and moody-minded. Why did you kill me, you bastards? Shut your mouth, fish face. Why will you eat my body? It's a sacrament. Be quiet or I'll give you to the cat. I touch the skewered salmon, testing for readiness, and burn my thumb on the sizzling skin. Hand to mouth, the thumb goes in, a childish pose for the man who knows the secret of the salmon. But what he knew, now I know too. This sacrament will have a hazelnut in every bite. Tertiary chaos. Stars fade. Dreamy night, displaced by dawn, is slowly drawn around the world. And weavers of words must wake into wide and warm, industrious day. But stay, I have a point to press before lucidity is marred by cruel day. Surely we have not come thus far to know the how and why and when. To be confounded by the what? Not since the days of Merlin did our land abound in wizardry, as is the case today. But, you interject, wizardry was easy in those days. The hollow hills and henges a simple matter of material relocation. See our soaring cities. I see our soaring cities, and from my weeping springs a stream in which the salient salmon swims sulkily to sea. He cannot go the old time way. Our soaring city turned his river red and unproductive. A feculent foss stinking its way to the reluctant source of life. I stalked him fair, but that was the last and final time. For when you tread that path beside the pool in time to come, you'll find no thrill in wrangling out a phosphorescent fish. The magic works. moment by moment, grows stronger. But Earth grows weak and cannot wait on prating politics. The tolerant trees whisper through the weird for quiet magic's aid. And I choose this instant from which to read divinely, seeing in the black mirror of chaos a green, unravished earth. Gripping that possible future, I choose this instant to plant the seed of my desire, sigil-like, in your confused imagination. The silent power of witch and wizard, magicians diverse of cloak and creed, joined just in this, to chart the earth a different course.